I want to talk to you about e-commerce store checkout. Into this conversation, I want to share with you a few hacks to actually optimize your conversion. See, the thing is that here is an overview I want you to pay attention to. So when we talk about e-commerce store, you have all sources of traffic, right? You can have traffic coming from social media. You have traffic coming from Google. You have traffic coming from PPC ads campaigns. You have traffic coming from landing pages. So you have a series of traffic sources that really point to your e-commerce website. But now the question is, once the traffic is there, how do you monetize that traffic? How do you actually increase revenue? How do you convert? The first thing you want to do is you want to streamline the checkout flow. That's very important. If you want to really increase your conversions, you need to actually streamline the checkout flow. I'm talking about making sure that a potential visitor can actually check out of your store real fast. Okay, you want to request only essential user details such as email, shipping address, and payment information. Don't ask for more. You want to experiment with a single page checkout form instead of a multi-page format if it reduces the number of steps. So this has to be part of your A/B testing strategy. And you also want to incorporate progress bars and timers to keep customers informed about their progress during the checkout process. This will increase a lot your conversion rate. The second thing you want to do is you want to offer guest checkout and promote free shipping. So don't force people to actually give you to actually register to your website or give you an email. No, if it's possible to actually have a guest checkout process, you want to have that. So you are able to actually buy. You want to allow people to buy stuff without the hassle of signing up. It's all about giving customer options. Remember that. It's all about monetizing, but also giving customers options. And if you make registration mandatory, you can push away up to 24 to 48% of potential buyers. That's crazy. But hey, listen, it is what it is. So if you want to boost your sales, you can offer free shipping. You want to forget about mandatory registration. And you want to allow people, all kinds of people, to actually buy from your store, not a problem. I mean, if they love your store, they will come back and register anyway. So that's something you need to really think about. Boss, welcome back to the show. It's really a pleasure to have you here. Make yourself comfortable. You are going to enjoy today's conversation. The third thing you want to do here is to follow up on abandoned carts. See, if you want to increase conversion rates on your e-commerce store, it's important to pay attention to those abandoned carts. So sending out reminder emails can make a big difference here. Just wait a little while after a cart has been left idle. Then you want to shoot out a personalized email. You can also retargeting advertisement. And also think about extra sweetening the deal with a small discount or a coupon to give customers that extra nudge. It's all about you. Remember, you are competing with multiple avenues here. A lot of folks online are trying to really, lure the attention of your potential visitors. So you gotta really stand out. So it's really great to have simple tricks that can really boost your conversion rates and bring in some extra revenue in no time at all. Next, you want to incur easy multiple payment methods, returns, and exchanges. So instead of just taking credit cards, why not open up to more payment options like PayPal, Amazon Pay, or hey, even cryptocurrency? Yeah. Did you know that over half of shoppers will zip through checkouts if they can use, their favorite payment method? Plus, if they can't pay the way they want, they might just abandon their cart. And what you want to do is you want to keep them happy by offering the methods that they love. It's all about providing the customer with some kind of flexibility, right? If you want to boost revenue for your e-commerce store checkout, you have to really offer flexibility. So before hitting that buy button, more than half of shoppers check out your return policy. It's all about peace of mind, right? So be upfront and super generous about returns. You can offer hassle-free returns with prepaid shipping labels. That's really good. That way, returning stuff is a breeze. And that's what customers want. Customers want options. Remember, they want options. So you want to make their journey as easy as possible. And do not forget exchanges as well. Make your exchange policy just as visible. that will encourage risk-free buying decisions and keep your customers coming back for more. It's all about, once again, flexibility. Boss, I want to quickly remind you of today's topic. We are having a conversation about e-commerce store checkout, and I'm just sharing with you top hacks for higher conversion. Next, you want to test personalized checkout and make contactless. Let me break it down for you. To increase conversion rates on your e-commerce store, you want to try multivariate testing. Test your checkout, personalize, and you want to make it contactless. Let me explain that. First of all, remember that each store has its unique vibe and customers, right? That's what we call niche. So it's really essential to keep testing and tweaking your checkout flow using handy tools like Optimizely and VWO. And you want to mess around with things like layout, messages, and images to see what works best for your audience. It's all about actually putting yourself in your audience's shoes and see what really works for them. Plus, don't forget about personalization. When we talk about personalization, we are speaking about you actually thinking about geography, thinking about chronology, and thinking about demographics. It's all about really seeing that you want to really tune in the seasons and see what really works. Okay, you want to use data to tailor the payment process for logged in users, giving them a checkout experience that feels just right for them, right? It's all about sticking to the demographics. What really feels right for an 18-year-old is not the same thing that feels right for a 35-year-old or even a 45-year-old. Things are different, right? Experiences are different. And the chronology is different. The season is different. And this is important. So in today's world, where social distancing and health safety are top priorities, especially in a post-COVID environment, contactless checkout is the name of the game when you think about it. So you want to make sure your customers can pay with Apple Pay or Google Pay so that you can minimize physical contact points. And if you can do that, this will be really, really cool for your e-commerce store. And if your average order value allows for it, consider adding a fast one-click ordering option for those returning customers. And it will only take them seconds to breeze through the checkout process. And the ability to actually have that will increase your revenue in a big way. So, and that's something you want to think about. Another thing you want to do here is that if you are trying to increase your conversions, you want to extend loyalty discounts. Let me break it down for you. This is one area where a lot of e-commerce stores do not actually see the potential here. So when we talk about loyalty discounts, we are speaking about you actually creating a loyalty, what we call loyalty loop. So you are trying to have those customers, as you want to retain them, and you want to retain them. And most importantly, you want to satisfy them. You want to add value. That's the bottom line. So when we talk about loyalty discounts, those have to be exclusive discounts, especially when they're checking out. This is especially beneficial for those who are making repeat purchases or are part of your loyalty program, right? The thing is that you want to actually cater to those customers who have shown interest in your store in the past and have been supporting you ever since. So by offering those perks, you can motivate customers to finalize their orders instead of leaving them in their cart. You do not want to allow customers to leave items in their cart. Additionally, think about offering more significant discounts to your most loyal customers as a way to entice them to explore higher tiers of your offerings. And this is kind of cool, especially when you have multiple pricing tiers. This is kind of cool if you are selling different, if your product catalog is pretty varied. If you have a one product catalog or two product catalog, this will not work. But if you have an extensive product catalog, basically, if you have customers who are buying, who are very faithful in terms of buying low tier or low priced items, trying to entice them to actually try the high priced items. That way you are always increasing the revenue. And most importantly, you are actually satisfying customers too. Of course, when they go for the high priced items, you want to give them some discounts so that they have an extra incentive to actually buy the higher priced item. And once they tried it, if they love it, they'll come themselves and they will buy, even though there are no discounts anymore. Okay, it's all about it, giving them a chance to try the product. By the way, boss, I want to quickly remind you of today's topic. We are having a conversation about e-commerce store checkout, and I'm sharing with you top hacks for higher conversions. Next, you want to present social proofs. I mean, we are in a world right now where it's really important for you to actually have a social proof, because the whole thing is that if you are trying to really entice somebody to buy from you, the big question is, why should they buy from you and not from the competitor? Or why should they buy your specific products? What kind of social proof do you have? What kind of reputation do you have? How long have you been in business? What's your market share? Remember, we live in a world right now where customers have several ways to actually check, to actually gauge the validation, I mean, to validate a product, to validate an e-commerce store, to make sure that they are doing the right thing. You have reviews, you have social proof apps, and so on and so forth. So you want to toss in if you want to maximize conversion rates on your e-commerce store, you want to toss in some product reviews and ratings from other customers so that you can really amp up your conversion rates, okay? And it's really important to understand that when you throw in those product ratings and genuine reviews from your customers, you can give your conversions a serious boost. It's like telling your shoppers, hey, listen, you are making the right call. Check out what others have to say. But remember, those ratings must be honest. Okay, do not try to really have fake reviews, buy reviews or whatever. No, basically, if people are buying from you, you want to ask them to actually leave reviews, especially when they're happy. When they're happy with the service, you want to ask them to leave reviews, and you are going to use those reviews later on to actually entice other customers, right? It's all about really going back to what I said a little earlier. It's all about making sure that the geography, the chronology, and the demographics of the review are really adding value to your particular e-commerce store. What do I mean by that? But when I talk about geography, basically, if you have somebody from Italy leaving a review, the review must actually be relevant to someone in New York, for instance, right? So that's the geography. The chronology, in other words, you want the reviews not to be too old. You want to have as recent reviews as possible. And the demographics also must be there, because you want to have reviews from all kinds of portions of the populations, all portions of populations, old people, young people, you want young adults or old, I mean, whatever. You want to have all types of reviewers actually in your review group. Next thing you want to do here is that you want to create a FOMO, okay? So when we talk about FOMO, we are talking about a fear of missing out. This is so powerful, because the whole thing is you are trying to let people know that buying from you is a good choice. Okay, leverage consumer emotions, particularly fear, and this is actually a powerful tactic to drive e-commerce conversions. And so when we talk about you actually having hacks for higher conversion here for your online store, it's important to understand that creating FOMO, the fear of missing out, prompts shoppers to make purchases promptly, especially when products are scarce or time limited deals are actually offered. But this has to actually fit the specific industry you're in, because if you are in an industry where people don't care about timing, whether they buy today or buy 1 year from now, they're not going to succumb, if you will, to that FOMO tactic. You want to be in an industry where timing is really important. For instance, if you are, you probably saw like those hotel reservations or those like if you were to buy an airline ticket, you have this thing telling you one person is looking at the same ticket or five people are looking at the same ticket. This is a FOMO tactic, right? But hospitality in general is a time sensitive sort of industry, so that makes sense. But if you are in a field where time sensitivity is not really that important, your FOMO tactic is not going to work. So you want to capitalize on visitors' initial interest. Even casual browsers can be motivated to become buyers. It really depends on how you structure your FOMO strategy, okay? So you want to employ tactics such as showcasing low stock levels and running time-sensitive promotions like flash sales. Those two, for instance, can significantly boost shopper motivation and conversion rates, especially, as I said before, if you do it in a strategic way and make sure that it fits the chronology, the geography, and also the demographics of the shopper. Next, you want to highlight security and trust features. So if you want to amplify conversion rates on your e-commerce store, you want to highlight security and trust features in terms of, the HTTPS, for instance, or the padlock. So given how often you hear about data breaches in the news, it's no surprise that your customers are really wary about sharing their card details online unless they feel confident about security measures. So what you want to do here is that you want to make sure to prominently showcase the trust badges and seals all the way through the checkout process and ensure that SSL encryption is in place and that user data is securely stored in line with PCI compliance standards. And also, it's really important to understand that you can consider tokenization as an additional layer of payment security. Of course, if it makes sense for your specific industry, because it has to make sense for your specific industry. The last thing you want to do into this conversation, the last thing I want to tell you into this conversation is that you want to use tools for assistance. And so if you want to boost conversion rates on your e-commerce store, use tools for assistance. I mean, there are several tools that stand out for enhancing e-commerce conversion rate, including you have a Lucky Oranges toolkit. This is a tool that offers visitor behavior analysis, and you also have dynamic heat maps. Okay, you also have a Hotjar. Hotjar provides insights via heat mapping tools and features. You also have another tool that's called Quantcast. And Quantcast Measure offers tag-based analytics with advanced demographic data. And Google Analytics remain a staple, providing insights into visitor behavior, traffic sources, conversion rates, and more. So use tools that can really help you actually bring your strategies to the next level. So bottom line here is what? The checkout process, when you think about it, is kind of critical in e-commerce. Think about it. You've spent so much time showcasing your product. You spend so much time doing marketing, branding, and so on and so forth. But basically, if people are coming to your store and they have and your store happens to have a high cart abandonment rate, you are going to lose potential sales, that's for sure. So to optimize conversion rates, you want to streamline the checkout flow, offer guest checkout, promote free shipping, and follow up on abandoned carts, and also providing multiple payment methods, transparent return policies, and contactless options enhances customer satisfaction and trust when you really think about it. And testing, personalizing, and ensuring security features are kind of vital when you think about it for a smooth checkout experience. And finally, you want to think about loyalty discounts, social proofs, and you also want to think about creating FOMO can further incentivizes purchases. And so you want to really have all that. You can't just have two or three or four. You want to use a combination of those 10 hacks to increase your conversion rates and boost revenue in the long run. Thank you so much for your attention. I really appreciate it. God bless you. I'll see you next time. Today was a conversation around e-commerce store checkouts, and I share with you hacks for higher conversion. Thank you so much. God bless you. I'll see you next time. Until then, remember, stay marvelous.